joined by a professional funny person and reportedly the hardest working man in comedy. It's Jimmy Carr, of course.
Great to see you, sir.
Nice to see you. Nice to be here. Nice to be on Hangover Television.
Oh, I appreciate you popping in. I really, really do. Now, you're a busy man.
Yeah, reasonably. I only work 2 hours a day.
Well, please, let me give you the evidence, sir.
Go on.
You had a gig last night, you're gigging again tonight. What happens if you stop?
I don't know. I haven't stopped. I've been doing comedy about 10 years, and I do about maybe 300 shows a year.
300 shows
Like a bunch of TV and then 200 tour shows.
How do you relax? I mean...
I mean, it's quite an easy sort of job when you get into it. It's quite fun. It's not like a proper job. It's not like a 9-to-5 where you actually have to do something. But you're just telling jokes to people that have got the same sense of humour as you for 2 hours. It's a joy.
The DVD is out for Christmas.
Christmas? Is it? Oh, yes!
Take a look at this. This is great.
When they're filming a commercial with chimpanzees, is to give the chimpanzees peanut butter. And the peanut butter sticks to the roof of the mouth of the chimpanzee, makes the chimpanzee go... Because they're not used to the peanut. They quite like it, but they're not used to it, so it makes them go... Makes it look as if the chimpanzee is talking. Well, that's also how they make Hollyoaks.
Guys, let me say something. You, sir, have got a lot of stones to come on this show after saying that. Our beloved Hollyoaks, what are you doing?
I'm just saying it's all done with wires, isn't it? I've got blindness when it comes to Hollyoaks. If Hollyoaks comes on, I can't tell which girl it is. Because they all, I mean, they're all lovely, but they all look exactly the same, as far as I can see.
I should say, though, I mean, it's been running for 14 years.
It's 14 years, and they still haven't done anything.
It's a titan of a show. Jimmy, stand-up is as close to being a rock star as you can get without actually being a rock star. Is that true?
There's no groupies in comedy. When there's someone with a sense of humour that's the same as your sense of humour, you don't feel in awe of them. You feel like they're sort of your friend. Because the other people, you know, there's a great quote about the shortest distance between two people is a laugh. Which is a lovely sort of idea, that it's that sort of, that sense of humour is, you've got more in common with a comedian that you have the same sense of humour as than some of your mates.
I mean, the subject matter in your stand-up, clearly, it's very risque. Do you enjoy stepping over the mark? Is this something which...
I do. I think the audience regulate comedy. It's just true. The audience know whether something's funny or not funny, and it's en masse. It's as a group. They either all laugh or no one laughs, and they go, oh, no, we're not having that.
You know, I love your comedy. I thoroughly enjoy it. I think you're immensely talented.
You're correct.
But the only worry I had after all that palaver in the press was that you were going to get scared and go to put pen to paper and you're like, ooh, I better not write that one. That was my only worry.
No, I think it's it does take you down a peg or two. When you find yourself sort of in the papers and people sort of go, we were really offended by that. And you know, they're allowed to be offended. It's not for everyone.
Well, let's talk about something everybody likes. Christmas, 2 weeks from now. You're going to be very excited by this. This weekend, we've been pulling crackers with various guests on the show. Yesterday, Jamila and Rick pulled a cracker with Sarah Harding from Girls Aloud.
Wow. Imagine. Imagine.
Would you like to get in the Christmas mood?
Yeah, let's pull a cracker with me. I quite like cracker jokes.
Are you... Wait a minute. You...
What, I'm just gripping?
But some people, they go like that, and I... It's
oh, not even that, no.
That's not the Christmas spirit.
No.
Just keep it back and... OK.
All right. God, the Welsh.
Yay!
All right, don't go on about it.
OK, what have we got here? Oh, this is a sweatband. Now, I know you're a fan of tennis, I'm going to give you this.
I tell you what, I look a little bit like a special needs Roger Federer.
Would you mind putting it on your head?
What do you think? I look a bit like if Roger Federer had been dropped on his head at an early age.
Yeah, sure. Let's find out.
I'll get involved in that. Oh, my... How tight is that? Oh.
Yes, you do.
You happy with that?
That is what.
You happy now, T4?
We're very happy. That's going to be our screen grab from the year. One other thing.
Have we got the joke?
Yes.
Go on. Give me the opening line. And I'll see if I can finish it.
Why would you invite a mushroom to a Christmas party?
Because he's a fun guy to be with, I would imagine, is the punchline.
Jimmy Carr, everyone.
Thank you very much.